Well, I think, I mean, just to be included in this lineup at all is very exciting, very gratifying. You know, to have made a film that is this, I suppose, unconventional and political, has been recognised by BAFTA is extremely exciting for me. It's just great to be here as well, with my wife and with everyone else in the lineup. This story epitomises the desperation of migrants coming to this country, and it's. You know, it's an extreme, surreal, outlandish example of the lengths that people will go to make better lives for themselves. So I thought it certainly warranted, telling. Absolutely. And I hope people see it.
What impact are you hoping the film has on audiences in general? What are you hoping they most take away from a screening of this film?
Well, I think hopefully people will start kind of opening their eyes and realising what's going on around them in this country and in Europe, and just understanding that, you know, a lot of people need our help.
This is a film that touches very strongly on themes of fear and prejudice and openness. I guess that's clearly been a line of dialogue about this year's awards season. Do you have any particular feelings about that, particularly here on the carpet at the BAFTAs tonight?
It's interesting. They're interesting themes. I think, to be tapping into that overall sentiment, with this particular film, I think I feel part of a bigger movement. So, I feel quite integral to that.
Aside from yourself, is there anyone else you've especially got your fingers crossed for tonight? A wonderful lineup of nominees, as always.
You know, I loved the film Carol, actually, if I'm honest with you. I'd like to see that take home something. I have a feeling that 45 Years might also. I think that's a wonderful, wonderful English film. Fingers crossed. Let's see.
What is coming up for you in 2016? What are your plans at the moment?
2016, I've just finished writing a feature. It's a very dark teenage love story. So hopefully moving into development on that this year.